All right, what's going on, everybody? It's April 2nd. It is Monday. I do have some news for you guys to update you on a few things. There's some software updates, some deals, and then also some Verizon news. A couple of phones have kind of been put off the software update list from Samsung. And then some up-and-coming rumors, speculations, and some hardware from Motorola and Apple. So I'll just go ahead and jump right in with some software updates for you guys. If you have a Galaxy Note 8 from AT&T, Verizon, Sprint, or T-Mobile, or even the unlocked model, you should now be receiving your Oreo update. I do think the S8 Active, whether it's through AT&T or T-Mobile, should also be getting it. So that's good news. Phone should be updating to the most recent Android operating system there. Let's move over to some deals. We'll start with the Samsung Galaxy S9 or S9 Plus. Buy one, get one from T-Mobile, getting you $720 off the second device of the buy one, get one. So this is available as of March 30th. That would be the start date. So it is active now. If you decide to make the second device an S9 Plus, remember it is $840. And the S8 Active, which is $850, also qualifies. So you just have to pay the difference. The situation here is you must activate two lines of service or, you know, have one pre-existing line, you know, complete the upgrade and add a second line to the pre-existing account. You'd have to put the devices over 24-month installment plans, down payments of $120 or $130 depending on your credit, and taxes are due upon activation. It can't be combined with Carrier Freedom or get out of the red promotions, but all other promotions, whether it's through Samsung or anything else, those can be used in conjunction with the deal. Deal number two, free 4 months of Google Play Music and YouTube Red. Two stipulations here: you can't currently be a subscriber to these services, and you can't have previously used this promotion before. A little bit of news on Samsung: the S6, S6 Edge, and S6 Edge Plus, and I also believe the S6 Active, they're at the end of their update support cycles. So I think these phones all came out in 2015. Now they're off of Samsung's monthly and security, monthly and quarterly security patch update support pages. So they've been taken off. So they're done getting their updates. Something very frustrating to some people, I'm sure, is that you're not going to be getting support anymore from Samsung. So unfortunate news there. Some carrier news from Verizon. If you're interested, they now have their open enrollment for Total Protection, which is available until May 31st. It is available starting today, I believe. Smartphones, wearables, they're at, I think it's $11 a month. There's an additional fee that can get you, it'll cost $13, but it does get some additional coverage. I'm not really sure. This page is showing me $11. When I looked it up initially, it said $13 per line, so you'll have to double check on that to see what they're actually charging. I'm not really sure. Basic phones and tablets are at $10 a month. I guess there's a discount if you go four or more devices, like smartphones. They'll bring the cost down to $9 per month, but it does offer next day replacements, repairs, $29 deductibles on screen replacements, and some tech coaching and different features like that. So if you're interested, open enrollment does start today and it ends May 31st. Some hardware news, let's go over to Motorola. The Moto G6, G6 Play, and G6 Plus are set to launch here in the next month or two. The announcement does look to be, you know, rumored to be for tomorrow. So the G6 and G6 Play for, I guess the sale will be May 10th for the G6. And it's a pretty nice phone. It's going to sell at $249. It's a budget mid-ranger, really, really good value for performance. It's going to basically look like the Moto X. Excellent cellular radios in these phones. Awesome LTE connectivity. Nothing crazy fast, but really good. The Moto Z3 Play is also rumored to be coming out soon. That's a little bit more of a high-end device. Not necessarily a flagship, but a very, very good device. That one's going to be released at about a $350 to $400 range. So Motorola's got some devices coming out that you might be interested in. I'll keep you guys updated as soon as I get more information on that here on the channel. Going over to Google, rumors of a third Pixel phone. This is interesting. So the Pixel 3 and 3 XL will be coming out in the fall for sure. Third generation of the Pixel lineup. But it looks like there's going to be a different Pixel phone that is going to be targeting a more affordable price range, something of a mid-ranger, I guess, availability by the end of the summer. Designed for emerging markets, i.e. India. So maybe not just, you know, India, maybe it does come to the U.S. or other markets. It's slated for July or August. As well as, you know, we'll see the third generation Pixels coming out at the end of September, early October. And another thing from Google, they've got a program now called Rolling Study Hall, which they're basically outfitting school buses with free Wi-Fi and Chromebooks, targeting rural areas of the U.S. where, you know, people just don't really have the technology, and, you know, whether it's an issue of availability or cost. But this is going to be available in 16 districts across 12 states: Alabama, Colorado, Georgia, Kansas, Minnesota, New Mexico, Oregon, Pennsylvania, South Carolina, Tennessee, Texas, and Virginia. So places where there's, you know, no internet access at home, this would give some of those kids some different technological tools that they can use. And I think one more thing from Apple. Apple's going to be moving away from Intel, using their own chips in their Macs starting in 2020. This is a major blow to Intel. I mean, from what I understand, somewhere between like 5 and 10% of Intel's revenue comes from Apple and using these chipsets in their computers. So, you know, and this is interesting because no other manufacturer, no other OEMs uses their own chips in their computers. So Apple would become the first. But you know how Apple wants to do things. They want to integrate their hardware and software together more effectively, more efficiently. So this gives them the ability to do that. So definitely a power move from Apple. That's it for this video, though, guys. In the upcoming video, I'm going to cover some Google news related to spectrum availability, some cord-cutting news for anybody who's interested in, you know, getting rid of cable. There's some YouTube and Netflix video technology news that's up and coming. So make sure you stay tuned to the channel, subscribe. Please like the video, share the video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.